everyone okay? So
what is the Living Inquiries? It's a method of self-inquiry, and it's about looking into our direct experience. The process
that we're doing is looking at how our thoughts, the impact our thoughts have on our, particularly around uncomfortable feelings, etc. And it can work in several ways. We can use it with deficiency stories. And deficiency story, I'll just keep it brief, is around, based around the theme of I'm not good enough, sort of the beliefs that we hold about ourselves being not good enough. And that can take on sort of, you can imagine how many different ideas we have of that. You know, I'm unworthy, I'm unlovable, etc., etc. There's loads of them. Anyway, so that's one particular form of this inquiry, the main one, the unfindable inquiry, it's called. And also, there's an inquiry that deals with compulsions and addictions. So you sort of get the picture. It's anything that causes us suffering, yeah? And what we're going to look at today is an inquiry that deals with anxiety, particularly anxiety, stress. But first of all, has anybody heard of Scott Killaby? Have you come across him? No?
Okay.
It is, yeah, Killaby, yeah. Yeah, he's just opened an addiction centre over in Palm Springs, actually, which is really, really doing great done sort of thing with working with this method with people with addiction and stuff. But I came across this method a couple of years back now, 2-3 years ago. Just looking online, just watching YouTubes, etc., and particularly stuff around non-duality. And he was first and foremost a sort of non-dual speaker. So watching that, and then came across this video of him doing this method, and I was kind of like, whoa, this looks really powerful. It took me a while to sort of, pluck up the courage to get have a facilitation myself with somebody called Fiona, who's a senior facilitator in this country. And I did that, and I kind of never looked back really, just found it, didn't quite know what happened at the time. It was just such a different different process to what I was used to, anything I'd sort of experienced before. But I liked it, and went back for more, and then decided to train in it myself. And I've just, as personally, I've just had so much, it's just helped me, amazingly, really. I've suffered with depression throughout my life, and I don't get depressed anymore. And anxiety, kind of all that sort of stuff in my pit, that black hole kind of thing. If any of you have suffered with depression, you'll know what I'm talking about. And yeah, it's kind of, that's fine. And also with addiction, I struggled with food addiction in many guises for years, ranging from anorexia in my teens, bulimia, compulsive eating, etc. And again, it's been an accumulative effect, but it's all just kind of really loosened, and it's just, I can't describe how freeing it is, how liberating it is to just not have that kind of like, that sort of feeling like, like even just eating a meal, thinking, oh, is there something sweet I can have afterwards? Oh God, have I got anything in? Have I got any chocolate in my cupboard? And now it matters not, which is really cool. So anyway, that's a little bit about how it's helped me. So what we're going to do is kind of just, I'm going to interact with you a little bit here, and we're going to just talk about thoughts and feelings. So for instance, thoughts, just let's think about how thoughts are made up. What are they made of? What happens when we have a thought? What's going through words? Images or pictures, yeah. We might see the words, we might hear them.
Feelings.
Yeah, or just thoughts at the moment. We'll come on to feelings in a sec. So thoughts, okay, are made up fundamentally of sort of words and images, yeah, whether we see them or we hear them.
Ideas.
Okay. Hey?
Ideas.
Yeah,
notions.
Yeah, exactly. Words and images again, how does that sort of present? And then we've got the feelings, yeah? So where do we feel feelings?
Body.
In our body, yeah. Yeah. So that's the felt sense, yeah? So we're dropping into our body and feeling those feelings. And what so let's have some feelings. What kind of feelings do we have?
Butterflies.
Could that be, what would you name that as?
Fear.
fear,
anxiety.
Sadness.
Yeah,
we've got all the whole realm of So of sadness, grief,
anger,
happiness. We've got a whole range of feelings, haven't we?
Euphoria.
Yeah. So, pardon? What did you say?
Euphoria.
Yeah. So we've got a whole range of feelings, that we can experience. So this, what happens is the feeling, the thoughts. We have the thoughts, and then we get a feeling. Okay. So it all depends on how in touch we are with our sort of felt sense as to how we pick up on those feelings. Because what happens then is we have a sensation, and Scott talks about the Velcro effect. So the thoughts, the feelings, and the sensations all get stuck together. Okay. So then we have these sensations in the body, and it can often be a contraction. People can walk around for lifetimes with huge contractions in their body, i.e. anxiety or, whatever, again, whatever it comes as. So what we do in this process is we very gently, but it's powerful, but we gently pick apart, we unvelcro the thoughts and the feelings and the sensations from each other, So if you were being facilitated, I one-to-one sort of facilitation, that's what I, as a facilitator, would guide you through doing. And we would look at everything that comes up. And we also do this from a place of deep relaxation. We call it deep rest, So we're resting with whatever is going on. We're just resting right here, right now, with our direct experience. Just letting everything be exactly as it is. Not trying to do anything with it. Okay. So these sensations, I'm sure you're all kind of like, you've got some sort of idea of what I'm talking about when I talk about sensations, when a thought comes up, why have we come here today? Okay, you might have seen that flyer that I was giving out earlier, stress and anxiety. What were your thoughts on that? What did you think? Oh, why are you sat here?
I've got some of that.
see what she's talking about me.
Yes. Okay, anything else? Curiosity?
Oh, I could learn something here. I'm
trying to learn how to deal with it.
Yeah, okay. So we're not trying to get rid of anything here. This is the wonderful thing about this process. We're not trying to learn a way of distracting ourselves from it, okay? We've got plenty of distractions, haven't we? Look out there, everything we use to distract ourselves from what feeling, just what is. Mm-hmm. Just being here with whatever we're feeling. Mm. And this is where the addictions and compulsions come in, as well as all the other things we distract ourselves with. Because it stops us feeling, it takes us out of ourselves, doesn't it? Mm. Even going shopping, look at all the things we can be addicted to, even our phones, all of it. That stops me from actually just sitting here, resting with what is. Mm. So this is what's so wonderful about this process, is that it encourages us to actually do that, to actually be okay with what is, to actually be able to feel what's going on without being scared of it. Because sometimes these feelings and these sensations feel so overwhelming that we don't think we can possibly stand it. Mm. So we continue to look out there and to distract ourselves and go everywhere else but in here, inward, So this is what we're going to have a go at. And I will be honest with you, I've worked with sort of smaller groups, smaller workshops this summer, and there's quite a lot of you here, and we've only got an hour, and I'm going to do my best to sort of help you out with some tools here. So just bear with me, and let's see how we go, all right? So first of all, does anyone have any questions about what I've already said, the Velcro effect and stuff, and about everything getting stuck together?
Could I ask what was on the leaflet? I didn't see the leaflet.
Oh, right, okay. It was,
Yeah, you can have that. Thank you.
Because it's probably quite a lot to sort of take in all at once. So I'm going to just ask you just to close, we're just going to close our eyes for a moment and just rest here. Okay, just take a few deep breaths. And just picture a lemon in your mind's eye and see if anything happens in the body, if you get any response to that. Just take a note of that And now next, just picture a tree. So an image of a tree. Just notice that. See if there's any bodily sensation. So it's dropping your attention into the body, really, to see what's going on there. If there's any response. And now picture one of your parents, your mother or your father.
Innocence in her eyes.
Yeah.
And then the parents one.
Yeah.
That was quite a shock, really, because it's like, oh.
Yeah. What happened in the body then? Did you notice a difference?
Yeah, I felt like in my guts they tightened up. Yeah, I felt a lot of sort of like
emotional.
Yeah, because I was sort of like with the other ones, it was quite innocent, and I was just like, oh yeah, well, that's you know, what's that's like. And then it suddenly I felt like I had to protect myself. I wasn't in control. A bit like with a lemon, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's fine, it just sits there.
The tree and the lemon were like okay, and after that was kind of, you could feel a pull.
Yeah. You feel
a bit. Yeah. So that's what we're talking about, yeah? So dropping into the body and being aware of these sensations, okay? And noticing the thoughts which I sort of led you to, led you with. How that gets, and then you've got an emotion coming in there, when there's an emotional response, because you know, we've got an emotional attachment obviously to our parents. Maybe to our cars and our homes, yeah? And how that velcros together, yeah? And then you feel it, yeah? And we can feel those sensations anywhere in our body. You know, mostly it's kind of here, sort of stomach, chest, throat sometimes. But you know, it's mainly sort of these areas. But you know, some people could feel in their feet and their heads and stuff, whatever. There's nothing right or wrong here. You know, whatever is being felt is being felt, and that's your experience. Okay.
Is there a reason why we seem to mainly feel it in our stomach?
Well, I guess that's where the term gut reaction comes from, doesn't it? A gut feeling, because we feel it in our gut, isn't it? And I guess if you sort of went into that, there'd be a lot more around that.
You know, so
the chakra,
is it a solar plexus or something down there? Totally, yeah. I often sort of think solar plexus. Yeah. It's kind of,
I've heard that about.
There's tons
of
nerves in the gut as well. Exactly, there's so many nerves in the whole of the gut that they make like 80 times the amount of serotonin that's in the brain.
Yeah,
really like it's almost
they call
the whole
it
nervous
the emotional
system.
Centre, don't they?
Yeah,
the
definitely.
Bowel. Yeah, yeah. So yeah, totally.
Like a second brain, I've heard. It's like a second brain.
They say the second brain,
absolutely.
Don't they?
Yeah, and also the heart. You know, so you get a lot of this in the heart centre, you know, depending on what you're sort of inquiring into, you know, you'll feel, you know, different sort of areas. And definitely I think it does sort of respond, you know, coincide with the chakras as well. You know, I had a lot of stuff going on in my throat, a huge contraction in my throat. It took me a long time to kind of just release that. And that was about self-expression, you know, that I've struggled with, you know, long time sort of thing from childhood, you know, and a lot of it is stuff obviously that's coming up from our childhood, you know. That we hold there, don't we? As memories, yeah? So there's a lot of stuff that we can sort of look into, explore and pick apart, you know, and these sensations and feelings and thoughts. Anyway, so the anxiety inquiry. So we all know what the fight or flight response is, don't we? Has somebody given ideas of what the fight or flight response is?
It's that automated response to fear.
Yeah.
That you either stand and you're excited or you flee. It's very, very helpful, ancient thing, isn't it?
Yes, yes.
Like adrenaline.
Yes, absolutely, yeah. And so the anxiety, I mean, a lot of people, you know, will go to their doctors and be told they have an illness called anxiety, won't they? Mm. Oh, you know, you're suffering with anxiety, stress, whatever it is. But actually, when we look at, you know, when we actually look into the body and you know, get to the root of this, the root cause of what's going on here with the anxiety, it's about the sensations, it's about the felt sense again, you know, and it's about the impact and the power our thoughts have over what's going on in our body, yeah. So that's a far, far more helpful way to look at this than, you know, kind of taking things and for anxiety and trying to find stuff that's going to distract us from it or help us cope with it. You know, a far, far more powerful way is to just explore it and see how it's coming about and sort of see through this. This process is about sort of seeing through that and letting it release. So with the anxiety inquiry, what we do is we look for a threat or we look for whatever other word resonates, and it might be different depending on how the anxiety is presenting. So it might be looking for a threat, it might be looking for danger or doom, you know, anything that's coming up in your life. There might be a situation, there might be a phobia, there might be something, you know, that really produces this fight or flight, you know, where it's just this whoo, you know, and you feel like it's insurmountable. So that's what we're going to have a little go at today. So we're just going to do like a sort of short one, just to give you an idea of it, okay, and to just start bringing these tools in to help you. So we're going to start with resting, pleased to know. Again. So I'm just going to do a little guided rest for you here, and then I'm going to ask you a few questions. But before we do this, I want you to just have a little think about, and we don't want to go anything too deep, so just think about something that might be causing you a bit of anxiety, something you might think, oh yeah, I'd like to look at that. You know, something that might be a little bit stressful in your life. Anyone got in any sort of ideas about something they'd like to maybe explore around anxiety? We can just look for anxiety and see what comes up. You know, that's another way of doing it, because it will, sure enough, sort of start to bubble up.
I thought about my, when we did home, didn't we, so I thought, actually, I'm not very happy with home. So that's what I was going to do.
Yeah,
yeah. Sort of my
yes, lovely. So that already started to. Yeah, great. Okay. That's great. Yeah, but otherwise we can just sort of go into it and just see what comes up. You know, often, you know, we go into a session, an inquiry session, and we're sort of like, right, I want to look at this. I want to look for this. And it goes completely off on a tangent and you're looking for something to completely, you know, different to what you came here for. But actually what's totally needs to be looked at. And so yeah, so don't worry about it. So let's start with some rest and we'll see how we go. So just closing our eyes.
Can we lie down?
You can, yeah, you can lie down if you want, yeah, yeah. Just closing our eyes and just taking a breath, deep breath, just allowing that breath to help the body settle. And just bring your attention to the sounds of the camp, people's voices, traffic in the background, the bird song. Noticing all these sounds seeping into your awareness now. And just bring your attention to the breath, the feeling of the breath in your nostrils as you breathe in and out, how it changes temperature. Notice how this breathing happens with no efforting. And just tracking that breath down, down, into the inner space of the body. And noticing a sense of energy and aliveness and sensations that constitute this inner space. And just letting it be here exactly as it is. Letting it do what it does. Notice its movement and how it even expands. It expands beyond the borders of the body. Into the space outside the body. Same space. And just noticing the sensations of sitting, where you're sitting, whether it be on a chair or the ground. Feeling into those sensations, those pressure points on the body, your back, your behind, your legs. And noticing how you're supported, how the ground supports you, the earth supports you. Noticing how everything is supported and supporting you. And just resting right here. Nothing to do, nowhere to go. Arise and dissolve. Just keeping your eyes closed, I'm just going to ask you to cast your mind to this anxiety, to the stress, something that's coming up for you today, a topic that you've chosen. That word or the image. Just taking a really good look at it, noticing how it hangs there in space.
Yeah, choo-choo.
And if you're just looking at anxiety, you can look at the word anxiety. Just see if that word is actually anxiety. Just notice the shapes of the letters and the spaces in between. Is the word itself anxiety? And whatever your answer, just dropping into the body, just noticing what's taking place there, any sensations. Breathing into the space. Just being right here with it. And then just continuing this exploration, noticing if any images are coming through around the anxiety or around your topic. And again, scanning these images, noticing the edges around them and the space around them. And just seeing if this image is actually what you're looking for. Is it a threat? Can it actually make you anxious? And if the answer is yes, drop into the body again and just go to that yes. Where do you feel it? the answer is no, just drop into the body again and rest with that a moment. If you're with sensation, if your attention is on the sensation, just exploring the sensation, just being gently curious about it, scanning it. And if there's any words that seem to be stuck to it, that seem to be keeping it there in place, just see if you can gently peel them away. Maybe the word anxiety or anything else that was coming up. See if you can peel it off that sensation or that energy and be with it by itself. And just continually breathing into this, breathing into it. Staying right there with it and just letting it be felt. Giving it lots of space and full permission to be here. Breathing into it and welcoming it. And if any other thoughts are coming through, just doing the same, we're just going to look again at the thoughts, the words, images, just scanning them, seeing if there's an actual threat on any of it. Can any of it harm you? Can the word harm you? Can the image in and of itself harm you? And if it feels like it can, drop into that yes, drop into that felt sense of it being a threat. And just get right inside that sensation. Just fully feeling it. Just letting it have its full shelf life. All the time it needs to be felt. And sifting through this energy, this sensation, see if you can actually find a threat in it. And another image might come up, or another word. So we carry on with the same process. Just investigating everything that comes through, every thought, every word, every image, and slowly unveiling it. So we look for the threat. Where is the threat on that word or that image? Drop into the body again and again. Where's the threat in the sensation in and of itself? Breathing into it. And if the sensation feels really sticky, if it's feeling uncomfortable, just see if there's something that seems to be holding it there, keeping it there, in the form of another word or sensation or words, or pictures. And each time just gently scanning them. Is that it? Is that the threat? Is it that word? Is it something on that image? dropping into the body, fully feeling whatever's going on there, letting it do what it does, not trying to do anything with it, just being right there with it. Breathing into it, noticing the spaciousness it occurs in. Can the sensation harm you? Can this energy be a threat? Resting here. Bring your attention back to the breath. Rise and fall of your chest. Feeling the breath in your nostrils. Feeling the sensations of where you're sitting or lying. Noticing the sounds of the camp and the engine. And just very gently coming back and opening your eyes.
It was interesting. I like that idea, the Velcro thing.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's quite difficult, isn't it, to sort of, to separate the. Yeah, but it's good to. It's good to. I can imagine it gets easier.
Yes, of course. Yeah, it does. Yeah. And honestly, you know, this is your first go at doing this. I'm pretty sure it probably is. So you know, thank you. And it's also my first go at trying to do it with a lot of people at once. You can imagine if I was doing it one-to-one, I could really follow what was going on for you. But so it was a bit kind of, you know, just trying to sort of encompass what everyone was feeling. So if it, you know, if it didn't quite sort of, you know, resonate, you know, don't feel like it's not for you sort of thing, that, you know, it's because, you know, you probably need to sort of do a little bit of a more one-to-one kind of thing. Anyway, just please let me know any questions or anything you'd like to share.
It made me understand a bit more.
Cool.
It made me understand and think, is that actually harming me? It's not.
Great.
It's not. And lots of. I can't explain it now that I'm not there.
Yeah, it's isn't it weird, because you actually don't know quite what happened.
Yeah. So, but no, I saw it, and I thought of what I was thinking of, and saw that place in me where it was, that sensation.
Yeah.
And all it was a sensation.
Yeah. And a lot of the time, the sensation will have a shape or a colour, you know, and you can explore that as well. Absolutely, yeah. Or an image, and sometimes it can be really frightening, really foul, you know, when we really go deep with this. But you know, it's all just to explore and to look through, and you know, it brings up huge, you know, you can imagine, But you know, I just wanted to sort of try and keep it fairly brief, not go too.
Yeah. And how you said about the word anxiety in your head. I thought, oh, anxiety is quite a beautiful.
Yeah.
Beautiful word, beautiful yeah. image. I like the shapes of it.
Yeah. And you can see it in certain fonts and things. Yeah. Sometimes. Yeah, so sometimes it can be really that. Spiky yeah. and scary, and then other yeah. times, oh.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes, it did, yeah.
Yeah.
Doesn't look as bad when it's quite nice.
Yes.
Is it, you know?
Yes. Yes.
Yeah.
I like the X in it. And first of all, it was like X.
Yeah.
It was like, ooh, X. Yeah. It's quite a nice word. Yeah.
That's great.
Yeah.
Anybody else? How did you find it? Did it give you some idea of sort of how to maybe, you know, notice what's going on when those feelings come up? Good.
I find it really interesting. What really resonated when you had to think of the feeling and you felt it in your body, and then you said give it space. And in my case, by giving it space, that's what actually dissolved it. And then when I thought about it again, it didn't trigger that anymore.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
It really kind of resolved.
Thank
that
you.
By
that's
giving
great.
That space.
Yes. Mm. Yes.
I find that
yes.
really interesting.
Lovely.
Yeah.
Really helps, doesn't it? Just those little sort of, you know, pointers. Yeah. Yeah.
I learned a similar technique just recently.
Cool.
And I had the feeling of this fight or flight. And it was during the meditation, and the guy had said to actually, you know, you name it and you find where it is in your body and the belt in the heart, and then it just got bigger and bigger and bigger. I was thinking, and then it dissipated.
Yeah, yeah.
I think it's a similar technique, isn't it,
yeah,
that you're using,
yeah,
you know,
yeah.
I felt with your guided meditation that it released, you know, you focus on it for so long.
Yes,
it
exactly.
But also there's another layer underneath there.
Yes. And it's just giving it our attention, you know, just putting our attention in the body and just seeing what's really going on.
Rather
than
avoiding it and pushing it. There's somebody here with
Sheila,
she's
had a turn.
Oh, God.
Let's send her some love then, isn't it? Pardon? Let's send Sheila some love then. Yes. Yeah. Yes. I thought she was here before,
wasn't she? I caught my outside as soon as I opened my eyes.
Pardon?
I caught my eyes as soon as I opened my eyes.
I see, yeah.
What's actually...
She's on the floor outside.
What? She's on the floor?
I don't think it'll help everyone going down, but...
No.
What do you mean, a turn?
She looked like she was having a fit.
Right.
There's plenty of people space.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's just finish off gently. Do anyone have any more questions about it? Or?
You'll have to give me a link. You'll think I'm going to translate.
No worries.
I've had a bit of in this space.
Yes, and that often happens, especially in a group environment,
and
you know.
It's a bit cold.
Yeah, it did drop, didn't it? I know. That
so
the sun went again. Yeah. I know, yeah. Anyway, thanks ever so much, everybody. So I know we, you know, usually this would be over a few hours or a day, so you can imagine, you know, really sort of getting into it. And,
you
know,
really got a fair chance of it.
It's really difficult to try and, you know, try and cram it all into an hour. But thank you ever so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Any questions? You know, just let me know. I do phone and Skype sessions. Pardon?
Me sleeping wasn't a bad thing.
No,
absolutely. It was great that you could rest there. Yeah.
I fell asleep. There was a cat running across the road, and then that train came.
Oh,
in your train.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Most of the relaxation.
And there's a lot more info online about it. You know, Scott's got a site and Facebook page and, you know, all that thing. Yeah, you know. Yeah. So, thank you.
Thank you very much.